Lotara Sarrin served as a commander of the World Eater's fleet during the Great Crusade and Horus Heresy. Given captaincy of the 12th Legion's Gloriana-class flagship, the Conqueror, at the age of 30, Lotara would be among the youngest naval officers to command a ship of such prodigious stature. A respected leader among even the savage World Eaters, Lotara would bear the honored bloody hand upon her uniform to signify her favor with the Primarch of the 12th, Angron. Expelling the Remembrancer Order from her ship, the cruelty within the Conqueror would prove to be difficult to record for posterity, for the only deeds worth retelling are those of the 12th Legion's betrayal of the Horus Heresy. Commanding the World Eater's fleet during the Shadow Crusade and Siege of Terror, Lotara would observe the rapid decline of her master's legion, yet lack the decency to reject her allegiance to the ruinous powers. The Conqueror would inhabit monsters, both material and immaterial in nature, and Lotara would stand as the sole commander, not afflicted by the ravenous thirst for slaughter and violence. Supplies and able bodies would rapidly diminish as the World Eaters gave into their mindless rampages across the ship to any who would stoke their rage. Attempting to leave the Conqueror alongside the World Eaters' destroyer sergeant, Skane, and Captain Maruk, the band would plot their escape. Securing 5 transport shuttles, Lotara would lead her band of men in their attempt to venture to the void frigate, Bestiarius. 4 vessels would escape the flagship, filled with deserters, as Skane and Maruk remained at the side of Lotara. Yet before boarding the final shuttle, the Astartes would be confronted by the equerry of Angron, Khan. Declared as traitors to the World Eaters, the Conqueror would fire upon the Bestiarius and destroy every defector of the Legion. The final shuttle would escape the Conqueror, yet Maruk would realize that Lotara was not among the shuttle's crew. Realizing his betrayal, Maruk would contact Sarrin, demanding answers for her betrayal, yet received no answer as Lotara commanded the Conqueror's guns to fire upon his ship. Killing Captain Skane with the conclusion of her scheme, Lotara would weed out the mutineers of her vessel and join the damned Legion of the 12th in their final assault of Holy Terror. Controlling command of the flagship with only a thread of sanity, Lotara would be wary of Angron's repeated murder sprees upon the Conqueror and require a means to contain him. Contacting the Lord Commander of the Night Lord's flagship, Gendor Scryvok, Lotara would, with the aid of Khan, broker a deal with the Painted Count. Transporting Angron within the bowels of the Night Lord's flagship, Nightfall, the Red Angel would attempt to break free from the maze within its hull, constructed by the Iron Warrior's Primarch, Perturabo. The only means to contain a Primarch, it would not be long before Angron's fury would tear the labyrinth from its foundation, yet it would prove sufficient in stalling his bloodlust until battle could be joined with Terror. Lotara would change into a sickly, weary, and pitiable shadow of her former self, yet remain dutiful in her command of the Conqueror. The voidship's machine spirit would sap Lotara of her very essence and incorporate her soul into its physical aspect. Lotara's mummified body remains upon the flagship's command throne, little more than a mutated husk, as her spirit, now fused with the Conqueror, would persist to serve eternal. For 10,000 years, Lotara's phantasmic visage would continue its duties aboard the Conqueror. The being now known only as the Mistress would be unaware of its state of undeath. The volatile and merciless spirit kills any who disobey its orders, and with the return of the Primarch of the World Eaters, pledges its fealty anew to the Lord of Red Sands. For even death cannot quell the duty of the Mistress, much to the dismay of the Imperial Navy's most stalwart heroes.